sin had entered the world. And it is interesting that there in Isaiah, it is almost a complementary picture of the book of Revelation. And just like Revelation 15:4 says, all nations will worship before God. Isaiah chapter 66, come with me there. It was our scripture reading. 66 verse 22, for as the new heavens and new earth, which I will make shall remain before him, saith the Lord, shall your seed and your name remain. The same idea that we just saw in 65. He mentions it again. And verse 23, and it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith the Lord. The Sabbath is still there. Even after a new heavens and a new earth, the seventh day Sabbath is still being worshipped. People will gather all over the earth to worship their Creator that seventh day once a week. Why? Because, as we saw, the Sabbath was not pointing necessarily to alone something that Christ was going to do. But the Sabbath is proof that when God says something, it's going to happen. And the fact that they are there proves that when God said, I'm going to redeem you, they're redeemed, so they're celebrating the God of the Sabbath. And so the Sabbath was instituted in creation. It has been kept throughout time, even though challenged the last 6,000 years, and for eternity, friends, we are going to be able to celebrate the Sabbath, not in a sanctuary, but in the presence of Jesus Christ. Amen. But what was the issue of the Laodicean church? It was that their walk did not match their profession. And Paul, under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, realized that they needed a clear picture of Christ as their Creator and Redeemer, so that their profession would match their walk. We must meditate not only on the cross, but the cross was made possible because Christ not only became man, but he was God, the Creator. Those that are transformed by the love and power of God will live the eternal symbol of the Sabbath. Not only that God is their Creator and Redeemer, but that the Word of God is living in their life. That is why the Sabbath, Revelation 7 and 14, becomes illustrated as the seal that seals God's people and is also equivalent to the name or character of God. The Sabbath and the character of God cannot be separated. And as we have seen through these studies, that's the problem with Laodicea. They have the form of the Sabbath, but not the character of God. And it cannot be the two separate, because the Sabbath is evidence that God promises that his people will have his character. And so, friends, may our lives be daily transformed by the Word of God. And that the Sabbath lifestyle simply be the symbol to the world that God is real, that God is true, and God is the one who can be worshipped, and we can approach in confidence because he has paid the price for us. May this truly be our experience, that we will truly find the rest of the story, not just in these portions of Scripture, but that the rest of the story of the Sabbath would be completed in our lives. Because it will be then that the people of the world will realize, wow, there is a group that follows the Lamb everywhere. There is a group that that not only claims to follow, but their life is patterning after their Christ. And I believe the many Gandhis will then one day say, yes, I want to follow the Christ of the Christian Church and the Christian because they are one and the same. If you want that experience, that you would be part of the rest of the story, experiencing not only the symbol of the seventh day, but the actual rest that only God can give you as He is your Creator and as your Redeemer, just raise your hand. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let us close by singing number 385, Crowning Jewel of Creation. Number 385, Crowning Jewel of Creation.